The best NBA slash rap slash music collab.
There's a long history of this in the NBA. Jason Kidd, Gary Payton, Allen Iverson, Ron Artest, Chris Webber, Kobe, Jack, Damian Lillard.
Dame Dalla, Lou Williams, Lonzo Ball. I feel like that's in the future for the Grizzlies.
It should be, right? We should get like John Jaren to, maybe we should do a song together.
Join Lang Whitaker and me, Kelsey Ray Johnson, every Thursday as we debate the hottest topics in the NBA. IMHO on GrindCityMedia.com, YouTube, and our social channels.
Kane Brown, Blessed and Free Tour. Saturday, October 23rd, FedEx Forum. Special guests, Jordan Davis. And Restless Road. See the meteoric rise of Kane Brown live. Tickets are on sale now at KaneBrownMusic.com. Presented by AEG Presents.
Represent Every Day, presented by Delta Dental of Tennessee, is an incentive-based program focused on keeping youth K through 6th grade engaged in school in order to combat truancy. In partnership with Shelby County Schools and with the help of Delta Dental of Tennessee, the Grizzlies are focused on reducing chronic absenteeism among the most impacted schools in the Mid-South. Students in the program have the opportunity to win fun and unique prizes by going to school every day and being engaged in the classroom. For more information on the program, visit Grizzlies.com/community/education today.
Don't miss the newest Grind City Media podcast, Infield Fly, with me, Rob Fisher, along with Lang Whitaker and Keith Murphy. Comes out each Tuesday, and we'll have the latest on our favorite teams and yours, regional and superstation teams, the Cardinals, Braves, and Cubs. While going around the horn to check in on the rest of the league, be sure to subscribe today at GrindCityMedia.com, iTunes, Spotify, and SoundCloud.
When you hire Nahon Seharovich and Trotz to handle your serious car or truck wreck case, we get right down to business. By sending out our rapid response team with all the resources to visit the accident scene, talk to witnesses, and consult with the necessary experts. To help you get paid for your injuries, call 683-7000. Hurt in a car or truck wreck? Think fast. Call Team NST today.
Call 683-7000.
WynnBET is live in Tennessee and bringing you the action of real money sports betting right in the palm of your hands. Now you can get in on the action with all of your favorite teams across NBA, NFL, NHL, MLB, MLS, and more. Don't forget to take advantage of the generous promos, great odds, and unique parlays available in Tennessee on the WynnBET app. Head to the App Store to download the WynnBET app and sign up today. First-time bettors will receive a risk-free sports bet of up to $500. Terms and conditions apply for all promotion. Get the details at winbet.com. WynnBET.com. Must be 21 or older and present in Tennessee. Gambling problem? Call the Tennessee Red Line at 1-800-889-9789.
My name's Tony Tornado. I write and star in my own shows and movies. My crew knows that I dream of Hollywood. They also know that I love Mountain Dew. But there's so much more they don't know. Sometimes at night, I look up at the stars and think, I know why Mountain Dew is so crucial to my existence, but does anybody else? See, Dew's the green gold circulating through my veins. It makes Tony Tornado believe that he can do anything. So now you know my secret. But there's so much more you don't know.
Do the Dew.
Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow. Friday, December 3rd at FedEx Forum. With special guests, the Marcus King Band.
You wanna drink a water, got to go to the well.
And Yola.
Take a ride out in the country.
I can be Yola.
On sale now. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com or the FedEx Forum box office. Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow.
Have gold? Bring it to King. Grab everything you'll never wear again. King will buy all your gold jewelry or trade it for new jewelry and get 20% more. Have gemstones or diamonds you don't want to sell? Sentimental items passed down to you? King can use your gems or diamonds and create a new work of art designed with your own taste and style. Trade in your gold, let King design something that's all yours, or sell us your gold. There's no better time than now during gold buying and custom design days at King Furs and Fine Jewelry in Laurelwood, where custom design is our specialty.
It's just a few cocktails at happy hour.
There aren't any cops around.
After every game, we always have a few. It's no big deal.
It was just a few drinks. I'm good.
Hey, I can hold my liquor.
I drink and drive all the time.
If you put away some drinks, put away your keys. Fans don't let fans drive drunk. Brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Safety Office.
Live from FedEx Forum, this is the Chris Vernon Show on GrindCityMedia.com. Presented by WinBet. Now, here's your host, Chris Vernon.
Here we go. It's noon on GrindCityMedia.com. It's Chris Vernon Show. Welcome, 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 welcome. It is the Friday. Oh, no. August 13th, 2021 edition of the show. I didn't even realize. Friday the 13th. Today on the show, we're going to be joined by two very prominent Memphis football players. Their starting quarterback, Grant Gunnell, who transferred from Arizona. The Mortell Award winner, our buddy Preston Brady, who is the holder for the Memphis football team. They're going to join us because we are going to change the NIL game as we're going to be making an announcement today on the show. They're going to join us in studio. We'll get you ready for the weekend. It's nice outside. Smile. Let's do it. Turn it up. Everybody's having a good day. All right. Like I said, we are going to change the NIL game a little bit because figuring out a way to get involved with this, and as you know, college athletes can now make some money off their name, image, and likeness. Preston Brady, who had been a friend of the show, who won the Mortell Award, made fast friends with Grant Gunnell, who is the starting quarterback for the University of Memphis. And we are going to be unveiling a web series that is going to be starting today with those guys. And I do think you are going to love it. It's going to give you the opportunity to get to know those guys as well as other members of the team. And I do think that people around college sports are going to see this. And as far as I know, I haven't seen anything done like this with any of the college athletes thus far. And I think for a lot of the fan base, they don't even know who Grant Gunnell is yet. So we're going to get that to that, and we're going to have these guys in studio with us today as we talk about this new venture. Before I get to anything, I welcome John Roser to the show. John Roser, a.k.a. the Cologne Ranger, the Body Spray Bandit, Senor Sack, Johnny Backpole, Johnny Bearcat, a.k.a. the Grim Roser, John Hustle, Johnny Asparagus, Johnny Net Carb, a.k.a. John Lance.
What up?
What up? Excited to have those guys in town.
Yeah.
Now, you were with me the other day as we were filming some of these episodes for their upcoming web series.
I was.
And one of the things you said to me was, my God, Grant Gunnell is huge.
He is huge.
Anybody
yeah,
that sees him, he's a legit 6'6". I mean, this is an NFL-sized quarterback.
Yeah, he is. He's a big dude.
And I actually reached out to our old buddy, who was our college football analyst many, many years ago, Noel Mazzoni, because it's crazy how the world goes round. Noel was his coach at Arizona. You know, he was on someone's staff there. And so had Grant. He loves Grant. talks to Grant all the time. Grant, I believe, went and worked out with him not that long ago. Noel told me that he was going to be coming in town for the Memphis Mississippi State game later this year to root on Grant Gunnell, and he had nothing but great things to say about him. And let me tell you, in his time, Noel has coached all manner of fantastic quarterbacks over the years and helped a lot of quarterbacks get ready for the NFL draft. Very highly respected in the quarterback community. So I'm excited for Grant. You know, we haven't seen him play a game yet. I'm excited for Grant, and obviously you have heard Preston on the show. He is a character, to say the least. And, you know, you get to know all these other Memphis football players as the year goes on. One quick thing I do want to say, because last night I was watching Summer League like I have been throughout this, and I've told you I've had a blast watching Summer League. It struck me, and I spoke about this at length, and you'll be able to listen to the Ringer podcast I did with Kevin O'Connor later on. But one of the things that struck me, and we've kind of seen this with Desmond Bane, Xavier Tillman, and the like for the Grizzlies. One of the things that struck me was, you know, so many of these second-year guys, Tyrese Maxey, Emmanuel Quickley, Bol Bol, I mean, you can go on and on. There's a bunch of them, right? Aaron Nesmith and Peyton Pritchard for the Celtics. Like, there's a bunch of guys that are like these second-year guys that are really showing out in Summer League. And you can say, well, that's to be expected. But in many cases, a lot of these guys, it's very, very, very difficult to serve two masters and develop young players and win games at the same time. And a lot of those guys were on teams that were expected to win last year. And we got to the time for it to vote for the all-rookie teams this past year. And there was like LaMelo Ball, and you know this as well, Roser, as a card collector. Nobody hits really except for LaMelo. There's some Anthony Edwards.
Yeah, but Edwards has some stuff that hits.
Really,
yeah,
LaMelo's the one.
Yeah.
Like, he's the one that everybody's going for if they buy a box of cards. You know, Halliburton, nobody cares about it. Like,
yeah,
he's a good player, but nobody cares.
LaMelo's the only one that you have a chance of in this year's class of hitting in, you know, some of the big, like, you could hit a six-figure card. You could.
Right. And I think what has happened is, and we'll see if I'm right about this. It was difficult last year to come up with like the all rookie team. People didn't think that that was a great rookie class by any means, right? I watched this Summer League, and this is what I think. I think it is my prediction that we are going to look back, and that rookie class last year was way better than we give it credit for, and that will flush itself out. And it didn't because, and people don't talk about this, there was no conference tournament, there was no NCAA tournament, there was no, everybody's in the middle of a pandemic. People are like trying to find gyms to practice in. There was no combine. There was none of that trainer stuff that goes on. Then they get drafted. Then there's no summer league. Then there's no real training camp. A very short preseason. And then you get to the year. So now you're in the year. There's no practice. You're not even practicing during the year. And so I think that it is probably unfair to judge that class based upon, you know, there were still some that were really able to produce, and I think that speaks a lot to them. Desmond Bane, Tillman, and others on other teams. Tyrese Maxey, you know, and some of them got real minutes for real teams. But I think that when you look around, there's I saw this kid. He couldn't get a minute for the Suns. You see that kid, Jalen Smith?
Yeah.
Had the goggles on. He was rebounding everything. He was banging threes. I was like, God, why didn't he get some minutes? I mean, they were playing against a bunch of oak trees in the finals. Like, he could have probably given you 5 minutes, some fouls, given Aiton, you know, a blow for a couple minutes. Like, I mean, he could have, I don't know. I watched him. I thought, like, this guy's talented enough. But again, 3 minutes, 4 minutes in an NBA Finals game could lose you the game, right, if you're a disaster. And he didn't play in the playoffs leading up to it. And, you know, it probably hurt them because they only had really one big guy. Aiton was kind of out there. Now, the ball comes off the rim, and he's fighting Lopez and Antetokounmpo and P.J. Tucker and everybody else. Biggest guy next to him is like Crowder, right? And then they tried to play Kaminsky a little bit. But, you know, who knows? That kid may end up being really good. You know, he didn't give any minutes, you know, last year. And I think that's true of a lot of those guys. Sometimes, and especially because of the shortened season,
they weren't going to really be able to develop. And because you're trying to win every night if you're like supposed to be a playoff team, and they didn't get minutes. And that's in addition to everything else that got screwed up for them.
Yeah.
You know? And so I think, I don't know, man. It strikes me that there's a lot more talent from that. I think people are going to be a lot higher on that draft. But that draft, that class is going to be take a little bit longer to pop because of the circumstances in which they came into the league. And I do think that there's some real, real talent in that class. For sure.
Yeah.
That we haven't seen yet.
Yeah.
You know, that really hasn't shown out. The Grizzlies are going to be playing again tonight. And we get to see Davion Mitchell, right?
Yeah.
This will be a tremendous test. You imagine he'll probably get the Desmond Bane assignment. So this is going to be fun. This is a real, real test. Because we saw Mitchell. I mean, look, the kid for Charlotte, Book Night, He probably wanted to quit basketball after that game. That was awful. I mean, he was just
handcuffs.
He was on his ass.
Yeah.
And then you gotta go to Twitter and see the replays all night. Like, of how you can't even, like, you had no chance of getting around that guy.
Yeah, everybody. Book Knight had an impressive first game, and then your second win.
Welcome to hell.
You're feeling yourself like, all right, man. And then the second one, it's like, oh, man, it's kind of a little bit of a humbling.
Davion Mitchell is no fun.
Not at all.
No fun. Welcome to hell. I guess that's why I call him off night. So we'll see if Desmond Bane has an off night. Real quickly, last night, in addition to the Summer League games, I flipped around. That Field of Dreams thing was awesome.
It was.
It was awesome. By the way, how does Kevin Costner still look so good? What kind of deal with the devil he got? That movie's 30 years ago, for God's sakes. You know, I mean, shouldn't he be, like, old? He doesn't even look old. Joe Buck said it hurt his hand when he played catch with him.
That's John Dutton. You know? Yellowstone.
Yellowstone.
Yeah. No, I mean, he might
He's
just
eternal.
Have, might just have great genes. He might. Or it's...
Dyes his hair, like Nick Saban?
Yeah.
So we don't realize how old he is?
He's also a multimillionaire and can probably afford ways to look... But, I mean...
He doesn't look like Kevin Costner's had plastic surgery.
No, he doesn't look like he's done, like, Botox or anything like that. Yeah, he doesn't look plastic.
No, and just that whole, like, game in the cornfield was totally awesome. And it turned out to be an amazing baseball game. 9-8, and, it, like, 6 runs in the 9th inning. Everything about that was cool. There needs to be a game out there every year. There really does.
Yeah.
And I need to go visit that. I've been told that you go to Iowa, it's not even like near, you know, I mean, hell, what? There's only a couple places you could even fly into in Iowa. And even
Des Moines.
But you ain't, like, you got to drive. It really is like in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, they said
like this place.
Yeah, the hotel 30 minutes away. Yeah, I mean, yeah. It's
you got to drive to the middle of nowhere, and you're really just going out to see Field of Dreams. So that's the kind of the hard part, right?
Yeah,
it's like you go all the way, kind of like at some point, maybe in my life, I'll be driving through Iowa for some reason or another.
Yeah.
But to go out of your way and then you see it and you're like, oh, cool, it's all Field of Dreams.
All right.
Then you turn around, you got to drive back forever. I don't know. But I guess if there was a baseball game there, I'd love to go to it. That'd be cool.
I think the next one they need to play on a sand lot. You know, find like a
dirty, and I know there's cynical dicks like there are with everything.
Yeah.
Field of Dreams is awesome, and if you're not touched by Field of Dreams, then it's just because you didn't you don't have a great relationship with your dad or something, right? Because I don't understand how you could possibly not any. Any guy that has the father-son relationship that I did with my dad, like, that thing breaks me. It breaks me.
Yeah, see, I don't have that.
No, right. You don't. But so it doesn't break you. You sit there and you go, man,
right.
Who gives
it? Well, no, not that. Not that. I don't like, I'm not one of those that, like, oh, Field of Dreams sucks. Right?
Yeah.
I don't think that. I mean, I don't think it's, like, awesome. but it's good.
Go.
I mean, it's good. It's a good movie.
But we have very different.
Yeah, I don't think it's bad.
You didn't resent your dad because you didn't get to play catch or something.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no. It wasn't.
But my dad, like that is my life. My dad came home from work. He didn't want to play catch.
No, I
wanted to get a Diet Coke and watch the Tom Brokaw on the nightly news.
I mean, what does it say about me that I think The Natural sucks? Like, I do think that movie sucks.
Oh, then you're just
yeah, like I
you're
don't
a bad
that,
guy.
I don't think that's good. I prefer
that's what that means.
I think I just like to laugh. I prefer Major League in the Sandlot.
You can't be trusted.
I prefer Major League in the Sandlot.
Well, those are both good movies too, right? Field of Dreams is awesome.
It is good.
It's iconic.
It is an iconic movie.
And that was super cool to see that last night. The other thing was there was NFL preseason on. And I did not watch that. You know, the disgusting football team were on. And the disgusting Philadelphia Eagles, they were on.
Did you see the Chase Young hit on Cam Newton?
Yes, I did see that.
That he made that look way too easy getting to the quarterback.
Chase Young.
He's a freak, man.
He's like an X-Man.
Yeah, he's different.
Yeah, I ain't with that. Dwayne Haskins. Mac Jones was like 13 for 19. That was cool.
Yeah, 13.
2 yards a pass.
13 for 18, like 89 yards. Yeah, they kept it simple with him.
Anyway, long story short, got to see a little bit. Kenny Gainwell did get some looks. 4 targets and also 2 rushes. So maybe Kenny Gainwell's going to get some playing time. They're already starting the Joe Flacco crap, though. God, I hope the Eagles end up with Joe Flacco instead of Hurts.
Yeah, Joe. Like this, I've never.
Please let them have Joe Flacco as their quarterback.
No. So, again, you card collector, like me, and I see like people doing NFL breaks and everything, and people are like getting excited about Jalen Hurts rookies, and I'm like,
what?
And so I'm like, dude, sell everything you have of Jalen Hurts. Like, he's fine. But like,
they're gonna put in Joe Flacco.
They ain't like, I mean, he ain't that good.
No, your playbook gets whittled down.
Yes, like he's not like he's a great teammate, but he's.
Yep. I'd say unbelievable SEC championship. Great story of staying ready when he got replaced by Tua. The whole thing.
If everything works out for him and he has the best career he can have, he's Jason Campbell.
Maybe.
That would be the peak for me. If he, that's what he would be.
So, anyway, those games were on. I guess, when does your guy debut? I'm going to have to flip it on.
We play tomorrow, I believe.
Oh, you don't even know.
No, I haven't even looked
You don't
it.
Even know.
We play Kansas City.
Good night.
Well, they're going to put the Chiefs have already said they're playing their starters the entire first quarter.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Nice.
And our starters are playing one series.
Okay. Well, good. Then Trey Lance will get to play a ton.
Yeah, he is. He is going to get to play. He's going to play the first half.
I can't wait.
He's going to play after the first from the second series to the rest of the first half. He's
first
play.
Game action since he played against Arkansas School for the Blind.
Yeah, Saturday.
Whoever Arkansas School for the Blind or whoever that exhibition game that he played where he was crap against.
We play 7:30.
First time he's played in 2 years.
7:30.
It'll be fun
Saturday
to watch.
Night. Yeah.
When he faces the Chiefs. I can't wait to watch it.
Me neither.
Super excited. You didn't even know what it was.
I knew it was Saturday.
I've got it taped. I knew what it was. I've got it taped.
No, you didn't. That's why you asked me.
No, I've got it taped.
No, you don't.
I've got to set it to record. So
you probably are. You're probably going to record it and send me videos of like every incompletion or every. I know you are.
I know you are.
No,
you ain't ready.
I know how
I've got that thing recorded.
I know you do.
We are going to change the NIL game with some Memphis football players. Preston Brady and Greg Gunnell are going to be in studio with us. We're going to get them set up after these words.
WynnBET is live in Tennessee and bringing you the action of real money sports betting right in the palm of your hand. Now you can get in on the action with all of your favorite teams across NBA, NFL, NHL, MLB, MLS, and more. Don't forget to take advantage of the generous promos, great odds, and unique parlays available in Tennessee on the WynnBET app. Head to the App Store to download the WynnBET app and sign up today. First-time bettors will receive a risk-free sports bet of up to $500. Terms and conditions apply for all promotion. Get the details at winbet.com. WYNNBET.com. Must be 21 or older and present in Tennessee. Gambling problem? Call the Tennessee Red Line, 1-800-889-9789.
I'm Corey B. Trotz with the law firm of Nahon, Saharovich & Trotz. We fight big insurance companies every day to help our injured clients get paid.
It's time for NST to lower the boom on.
Call 683-7000 because our team of lawyers knows the law to help convince the insurance companies on why our clients deserve more money.
That's NST strong.
I'm Corey B. Trotz, and we'll work to get you lots.
NST is the way to go. Call 683-7000.
877-0-0-0.
Horseshoe Tunica is your place to watch all the Memphis Grizzlies games. You'll catch every dribble, every pass, and every swoop. Whether you're looking to grab some food or meet up with friends, Horseshoe is the place to be. Come in today and see why Horseshoe is your favorite place to watch all the action. Horseshoe Tunica, official partner of the Memphis Grizzlies. Must be 21 or older to gamble or attend events. Know when to stop before you start. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700. Represent Every Day, presented by Delta Dental of Tennessee, is an incentive-based program focused on keeping youth K through 6th grade engaged in school in order to combat truancy. In partnership with Shelby County Schools and with the help of Delta Dental of Tennessee, the Grizzlies are focused on reducing chronic absenteeism among the most impacted schools in the Mid-South. Students in the program have the opportunity to win fun and unique prizes by going to school every day and being engaged in the classroom. For more information on the program, visit grizzlies.com/community/education today.
Have gold? Bring it to King. Grab everything you'll never wear again. King will buy all your gold jewelry or trade it for new jewelry and get 20% more. Have gemstones or diamonds you don't want to sell? Sentimental items passed down to you? King can use your gems or diamonds and create a new work of art designed with your own taste and style. Trade in your gold, let King design something that's all yours, or sell us your gold. There's no better time than now during gold buying and custom design days at King Furs and Fine Jewelry in Laurelwood, where custom design is our specialty.
The sun is out. That's a new development since the last time we sat here, and it is so hot.
It is brutal. But I'm born and raised here, and every summer it hits you like a ton of bricks, and you're just thinking to yourself, you would think I'd be used to it by now. And every summer I think to myself, why do I not have braids right now? Like, why do I do this to myself every summer?
Rise and Grind with Jessica and Megan. Live daily at 8 a.m. on GrindCityMedia.com.
Welcome to the Spicy Drive-In. May I take your order?
Can I get the spicy chicken sandwich, please?
May I make a beverage pairing recommendation this evening?
Sure.
I would recommend the Mountain Dew with that. It's bravely unrestrained with a very alive aroma that pairs wonderfully with your spicy chicken.
Yeah, that sounds amazing.
The muscular flavor charge characteristics of Mountain Dew make for an absolutely epic mouthfeel when paired with spicy cuisine. It is quite on point, sir.
Like they were made for each other.
When you want to make good food bolder and bold food better... do the do.
So you know how part of the reason they did the possession era is because referees can't throw a ball 6 feet in the air
right.
Straight up. Now we have drone technology. So we put the ball on a drone.
On a drone.
Fly it over the thing. Have the drone sponsored. Have it sponsored. You put a camera up there. Put a sponsor on it. Hey, guys, it's time for the Mountain Dew drone jump ball. Thing flies out there. Perfect every time.
Get your sports betting picks and trends with Lang Whitaker and Rob Fisher, the odds couple.
Grizz fans, the official Grizzlies mobile app is your key to the game. It's an all-in-one experience. Keep track of a team with news, social media, and team information. Plus, you can log into Grind City Media for articles, videos, podcasts, and streaming content like the Chris Vernon Show and Rise and Grind. You can see what's going on at FedEx Forum and use the app as your ticket and mobile wallet for contact-free payment in the arena. The official Grizzlies mobile app, your key to the game.
It's just a few cocktails at happy hour.
There aren't any cops around.
After every game, we always have a few. It's no big deal.
It was just a few drinks. I'm good.
Hey, I can hold my liquor.
I drink and drive all the time.
If you put away some drinks, put away your keys. Fans don't let fans drive drunk. Brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Safety Office.
Welcome back to the Chris Vernon Show on GrindCityMedia.com. Presented by WinBet. Now, back to your host, Chris Vernon.
Leave the back door open for me. Put your keys in under the door on time. Seems we've been waiting for a long time. My delay surely will be a crime. You know that we can do anything. I know that you can do everything.
You said that we should try many things. Let's make an hour so we can do everything.
You put a 20% deposit down, you can guarantee yourself the best seats at the lowest prices for this upcoming Grizzlies season. The 21-22 season, you're seeing all of the young players playing at Summer League out in Vegas. They've got a game today against the Sacramento Kings. And you're going to be able to watch Jaren Jackson, John Morant, and the rest of them in person next year. You can become an MVP, and you can get all kinds of deals with that. Grizz Next Gen, you can call it 888-HOOP or find them online at grizzlies.com. So, as we have talked about many times over the course of the past couple of weeks, college athletes can now make money off of their name, image, and likeness. And so, upon that announcement being made, I received a call from Preston Brady that said, pay me. No, I'm kidding. Wanted to come up with an idea to get some college guys involved with the show in Grind City Media, and we have done just that. It is going to be, I guess, name to be decided. Let me get you both close to the microphones. Preston Brady and Grant Gunnell are both here. In studio, get close to the microphone. Goodness, I got to teach these guys how to be media professionals. Well, for goodness,
you
just
pull the mic.
You can pull the mic.
You can maneuver it. You can mess with it.
You were the Mortell Award winner. That's the last time.
Holder
of the year in college football. So that was big, yeah. Right? How many times has he told you that, Grant?
At least 25.
All right.
Probably more than that.
If anyway, he fits it in every other sentence, actually.
We do not know the name of the show yet, but I'm told it is going to be unveiled this afternoon. It's going to be a web series with you two, where we are going to get to know not only you but the Memphis football team. And we filmed a couple. We got a couple in the case. You guys got some real characters on this team.
Oh yeah,
for sure.
Nothing but the best.
No, you do have good characters, and now, with this name, image, and likeness, you can make money off of your talents, which are obviously
holding.
Huh?
Holding.
Oh, no. I was talking about
thanks to the NCAA.
Being on camera, thanks to the NCAA. All right. I don't know if anybody knows Grant Gunnell yet, do they?
Nope.
I don't think they
have. You done any interviews or anything?
No, sir. I'm not allowed to yet.
Oh, you're not?
Mm-mm.
Oh, well.
This is strictly an NIL deal. So.
Oh, this is an NIL. Yeah. Okay. So you can't get in trouble for this?
No, not for NIL.
Okay. How did you end up here?
After I entered the transfer portal, it just kind of happened. I ended up being up in Memphis. I was recruited by Memphis out of high school, but.
By who?
Coach Silverfield.
Silverfield.
And Coach Dickey, he was here, but now he's at A&M.
Oh, yeah, Daryl Dickey. So, all right. So, when you were coming out of high school, you were an outstanding high school player in Texas. You won the Built for Truck Texas Player of the Year, right?
Yes, sir.
Which is the biggest trophy. Stop calling me sir. Good Grant.
It's a Texas
thing. I know it is, and I respect it. The biggest trophy ever, and you broke like a billion records in Texas, right? Like, and you break records in Texas, it's like Drew Brees and Matt Stafford and Kyler Murray, at like, right? There's like a million guys. Yeah. So which was the big record that you broke?
Passing yards all time.
Which was who?
I believe it was either Nick Foles or Drew Brees.
One or the other.
Both Super Bowl champions.
How many passing yards was it? Do you know the exact number or do you?
No, sir.
Just roundabout.
It was 16,000. Something.
16,000. Now, where did your receivers go? Because I need to decide what kind of level of credit we're giving you for the 16,000.
I had one receiver go to A&M and another one came to Arizona with me.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Is he still in Arizona?
Yes, sir.
Oh, he is. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So when you were coming out of high school.
16,108 passing yards, 195 touchdowns.
Come on, bro.
Both state records.
Did you guys ever run the ball?
No, we actually didn't have a running back at one point. we were empty set.
You really didn't?
Every game we were empty set my junior year.
No running back.
If we had a running back. We had a receiver come play running back if we needed it.
Third and one. Doesn't matter.
Empty set.
Empty set.
Yes, sir.
How many rushing yards did you have?
Is there a lot? Do you have?
I think did I not up, say rushing yards.
I think I ended up with like 1,500 career.
Wow! So he ran the ball too. Quarterback sneak.
That's not a little number.
Right. I mean, it is compared to the passing.
Oh, just 1,000.
Well, yeah. Compared to the passing yards, it was small. Okay, so when you were coming out of high school, who's recruiting you? You say, yeah, Memphis was in there at that time. Arizona. Mm-hmm. Where else are you deciding between? And how does a kid from Texas that breaks all these Texas records end up at Arizona?
I was actually originally committed to Texas A&M.
Oh.
With Coach Sumlin and Mazzoni.
Oh,
and then
okay.
They ended up going to Arizona. That's how I ended up at Arizona.
So you followed Sumlin when he was gone from A&M.
Yes,
you
sir.
Wanted to go wherever he was going to go.
Yes, sir.
Were A&M fans mad at you?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Mad.
Yes, sir.
What happened?
It was a little... They got a little mean on Twitter, Instagram. You know how it goes on social media.
Yes. They were not happy with you.
No, sir.
Okay. And then you go to Arizona, and how long are you there?
2 years.
And do you redshirt the first year?
No, sir.
So you're coming in with 2 years remaining.
Well, last year was a COVID redshirt.
So you get 3 years if you need them?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the time at Arizona, take me through it and what it's like.
Started off really good and then went downhill really fast.
Why?
I think we started off 4-1 or 5-0, and then we didn't win the game after that. it was bad.
In terms of playing quarterback, because your numbers are good there, right? When you got the opportunity to play, it feels like you made the most of it because your numbers are good.
Yeah, 15 touchdowns, 3 picks.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we weren't winning, though, so it didn't really...
You didn't care.
No, sir.
It was still not fun.
It was frustrating.
It was still not fun. In terms of college football and the transition from high school to college, and you're like, you know, now you're playing in the Pac-12, did you feel like it was more difficult than you thought it was going to be, that it was easier than you thought it was going to be, or was it about what you expected?
It was about what I expected. It was a lot calmer in the game than you expect. Just everything is toned out when you're playing, honestly.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
All right. So... Now you enter the transfer portal, and where are you deciding between?
I committed to Memphis right away.
Immediately?
Yes, sir.
As soon as you mm-hmm. were going to leave, as soon as someone was gone at Arizona?
As soon as I was in the portal.
Vernon, you want to hear something messed up?
Yes.
So, coach tells me we got this new quarterback coming in. I'm like, okay. I looked him up on Instagram, followed him and everything. And I DM'd him. And I said, hey, bro, you come to Memphis? He was like, yes, sir. That's all he said. And then I said, yes, sir.
I said,
when are you coming? No response.
I didn't know.
No response.
Wait.
Then I messaged him again. Still no response. And then he gets here.
What's his problem?
He messaged me once. I didn't know when I was coming, so I didn't respond.
What?
He messaged me once. He's... Camera's here. He's trying to, you know, make the
story. All right. So, how did you guys become friends, like quickly? Because Grant, let's be honest, he's not in your huddle.
He was the first person I met here.
Oh, he was.
Mm-hmm.
Because he DM'd you.
Well, he happened to throw, and
I met him.
I think it says a lot about you that you would be such good friends with a guy on special teams. Because I think there's a lot of guys that don't respect special teams in the manner in which they deserve to be respected.
I agree.
It's a big part of the game.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
If he screws up.
Yep. I mean.
It could affect
everything.
I mean, it affects our relationship because, like, if he doesn't do his job, then I don't get to play.
That's right.
Yeah. You
know? That's right. You don't. You might not even get to play in the game.
There might not be no holder of the year if he's not doing his job.
If you don't get to hold.
Yeah. Well, exactly.
So, right.
So,
I think
I think it says a lot because there's always that story. We say it about Tom Brady. Even the practice squad guys.
Yep.
He shakes their every time there's somebody new on the practice. He shakes their hand, introduces himself, and learns their name.
All right.
Makes them feel important.
So, you've been a Memphian your whole life, Preston.
Yes, sir.
Fun fact: my dad was born South Haven.
What?
Baptist Hospital. Yep. He lived in Memphis.
Really?
Yeah. His dad owned.
This is a fun fact.
Dad owned a liquor store by Sun City Records.
Sun Studio?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Right down here?
Yeah, somewhere around there. Yes, sir.
Wait, your grandpa?
Mm-hmm. I never met him, but...
Your grandpa owned a liquor store by Sun Studio?
Around there, yeah. Yes, sir. If I remember correctly from my
dad. So were your grandparents from here?
Yes, sir. Then they moved to Arkansas.
Oh, then they moved
later on. Later on, yes, sir. When my dad was growing up.
And that's how did your family end up in Texas?
I don't know that story. I think my dad told me just because it was good football for his kids.
Is your dad a giant?
He's like 6'4", 6'3".
You got brothers and sisters?
Two older brothers.
And they're?
One's 5'10".
Oh, okay. He hates your guts. He hates you. Well, you're 6'6", right?
Yes, sir.
All right, 5'10", and then what's the other brother?
He's like 6'3". He's a football coach at Central Arkansas.
Oh, he is?
Mm-hmm.
The head coach?
No, running back coach.
Running backs coach.
Yes, sir.
And then what's the oldest brother do?
That's just the two. Oh, my middle brother's the 5'10"-ish one.
And what does he do?
He's in law school right now.
He's in law school. Yeah. All right. So he can be your agent.
Yes, sir.
Yes. How about that, though, of all things? He has a family connection to Memphis.
Yeah.
After all. All right. Do you have culture shock when you move here?
Not really, no, sir.
No.
No. I was happy I'm back in the South. I had a culture shock when I got to Arizona.
What's it like there? What's different?
It's just the people are off. Not just the Tucson.
What do you mean the people are off?
West Coast. I'm not from West Coast, so. It's just different. It's a different vibe.
What do you mean they're off?
I don't know. I'm not taking any shots. You want me to take a shot? I'm not taking any shots.
What do you mean they're off?
I'm not taking any shots.
They're weenies?
They're weenies. The tanning beds.
No, it's just West Coast. West Coast is a different vibe than
Southern. Blonde tips.
Yep.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
Oh.
Not like that. Not like that.
I didn't say any of that.
That's what he's
saying. They're ninnies.
I didn't say that.
You said the Pac-12 is a bunch of
ninnies? I didn't say any of that.
Yeah. I mean, I from what I gather from the internet, there's not a shortage of pretty girls in Arizona, though, right? And Arizona State are pretty well known for being a good place for a college guy to go to college, no?
I'm sure.
You don't feel so?
No comment.
You didn't feel that way?
No comment.
You didn't feel that way?
He said no comment.
No comment.
I've seen the Tosh.0 episode of when he was at Arizona State. Now, Arizona State's impressive.
Well, they're well known.
Yeah.
And that's more of a party school, right? Arizona's not. Is it a party school?
Yeah, yeah, yes, sir. There's, there's helicopters every night trying to shut down parties.
Helicopters?
I'm trying to sleep. I only hear his helicopter flying around.
Trying to shut down parties?
Yeah.
No.
Yes, sir.
Wait.
Yes, helicopters flying around.
Is he being serious?
I'm so serious.
He's told me that
they
before.
They got helicopters on campus?
Mm-hmm. What? Shining lights on houses.
Wait, was this because of COVID or was this because of...
Wait, is this Tucson police or is this University of Arizona police?
It was Tucson police. It had to be Tucson police.
Okay, so the University of Arizona police has
what
a helicopter...
What the heck is going on? So you just had to get out of there. These helicopters overhead breaking up parties. Enough with this.
Now you get a train.
Yeah.
Now you get a train.
Now you get the train waking you up?
No.
Nope. You're nowhere near the train?
I am by it, but I haven't woken up from it yet.
Yeah, okay.
A little heavy sleeper.
Don't get stuck by that train, though.
Mm-hmm.
In the morning, like if you're going in the morning.
It's the worst.
Oh, it's the worst.
It is the worst.
Sometimes it'll slow down.
It'll just sit there.
It has to be on purpose.
All right, so you guys started practice last week, right?
Yep.
All right, tell me about it so far. How about you? Let's get it from both of y'all's perspectives because you've been around here for 10 years. This is year 10, right? He's trying to break Sam Kraft and what was the other kid's name? Jackson Dillon's record.
I'm getting close. I'm getting really
close.
Can
you get a seventh year?
Shoot. Then that means I got to play with my brother. Because you know my brother's coming next year.
Oh, that's right.
So I think I'm just going to be like, hey, I'm done.
So you've been around. You've seen a bunch of different iterations of this team. What do you gather from this year's Memphis team just from being at those practices for this last week and kind of seeing what you guys have?
Oh, I'm excited. I think that the team's different in the way of, like, every year since I've been here, we've kind of had, like, a good mix of, like, freshman, sophomore, junior. It's kind of been all mixed together. But now, like, our team is older guys and younger guys. Mm. Like, there is no
– middle?
There is no middle. And I think that's good in the aspect of, like, the guys like Jacoby Francis, Thomas Pickens, the older guys, me, even though people don't really listen to me a lot. But in the aspect of they get to show the younger guys what the standard is because they've been here.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think it's taken a minute, but I think it the younger guys are starting to pick on. So I think we're slowly getting better every day, and I think that that has a lot to do with it. Just because now the younger guys aren't just doing stupid stuff to where coach is just yelling at them because their locker's dirty, or they're not running off the field, or if their helmet's off, they're not standing up. Mm-hmm. So I think it's a good. I just think that's really good for Memphis football because like. You've always had guys in the past who have known the standard, whether you're a sophomore, freshman, junior, senior. There's always been guys who've known the past. But now it's a bunch of new guys who don't know how the past was, and now the older guys are starting to show them how it was. And
that's
what it's
interesting.
Like.
What about can you see a difference in Silverfield from year one to year two? Because he was really thrown in the fire.
Yeah.
You know, coaching the bowl game, and then you turn around and you get – your first year is the COVID year.
Right. I think that he has a little bit more juice to him now just because, like, the whole COVID thing was just weird. Like,
it's weird.
He couldn't, like, get in somebody's face and yell or, like, because, you know, you had to be 6 feet apart. But now, you know what I'm saying?
I didn't even consider that.
Yeah, no. Like, you couldn't get close to yell at somebody. But that's now, right. If somebody's messing up, he can get in. He can get in and yell. So, I think it's good, though. I think people are – because, like, last year was just weird because, like – he would yell. He'd be yelling from a distance, and you'd be like, whatever. But now when he's in your face yelling, you're like, all right, okay, got it.
And you were always going to deal with – there's going to be, no matter how much you feel like you have universal love from the team, there's always going to be some guys that are like, this is not who I signed up to play for.
Right, right.
Right? I signed up to play for Mike Norvell. Right. And no offense to anyone, right? Like, I mean – even in your situation, right? You signed up to play for Kevin Sumlin. I understand, right? Like, I came to school here because I wanted to play for Kevin and Noel Mazzoni. And then when that's not the case anymore, then if they have their opportunity to transfer, but then even if they don't, there's going to be a portion that are like, this isn't the same as what I thought I was signing up for. But it seems like he got through that very well, and you guys were still able to have a good year. Right. Last year, right?
Yeah.
And now you move into this year, inevitably you're going to be more comfortable. What about you and your impressions of being here, kind of what the program is like, what Silverfield is like? Because
the Memphis grind's real. They really work here. Yes, sir.
A lot more than that sissy peck.
No. That came out of his mouth. Not come out of my mouth.
It's not even the same.
They were too hungover to practice.
It's football here, Grant. All right? There ain't no helicopters out because we're not partying. We're footballing.
Oh, yeah. That's all it's about.
In all seriousness, what is it? Like, you. The first thing was?
The Memphis grind's real. We work here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yes, sir. You're not going to work. You're not going to last here at all.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and do you feel like it's just like a culture thing mm-hmm. that they it's have gotten cool, going it's a, there?
It's Coach says thing. That all the time.
Really?
If this is not for you, then leave. If you're not about it, get out.
And you feel like everybody kind of pulls the same rope.
I think everybody's mm-hmm. bought in yep. now, yeah.
And if you're not bought in, someone's either going to make you buy in or
you're out.
Yeah. So what's been the biggest adjustment for you? Obviously, when you decide to transfer, you're going to get a playbook. And so the offense as compared to what you've been used to playing both in high school and in college mm-hmm. At your time at Arizona, and then kind of just the way that Memphis football team runs as compared to what you've been used to.
Yeah, the playbook's a lot more complicated here. And it's just like any playbook, though. You have to sit down and learn it, take time out of every day to learn it, so you sit down and do that. But besides that, like I was saying, you know, the grind's real. If you don't buy in, you won't make it here. You have to buy in completely.
Had you paid attention to what Memphis was doing?
With Norvell, yes, sir.
You had?
Mm-hmm, yes, sir.
So you knew about the new
about,
year's
I knew
game
about Brady White.
I
knew about Brady White and the offense and numbers he was putting up.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And so now, as you walk into it, do you feel like you got to live up to that? Do you feel some level of pressure? Because, they have had, in between, you know, Paxton, straight to Riley, straight to Brady.
Right.
I mean, the quarterback play has been very high caliber. It has.
I mean, yeah, there's a certain level of pressure, but that comes with playing quarterback or any position, you know.
Yeah.
When you play the sport, pressure is really a privilege. If you don't want the pressure, don't. you don't want to be a starter. So, I mean, the pressure's always going to be there.
Yeah. Did you hoop?
I played a little center, and I was varsity center freshman and sophomore year.
And then what? You just gave it up? Were you awesome?
I had a couple double-doubles. I think I had a couple double-doubles.
You're tall.
Mm-hmm. Hey, he can shoot now.
I mean, he's legitimately tall. He's 6'6".
He can shoot.
Oh, I know. The first time I met him, he's like, when do I get to play John Moran and horse?
I still need that horse.
We need that to happen. So, if Jaw's watching, we need this to happen.
I know. That's a straight HORC.
You don't want that. You got to throw a lot of touchdowns to get to play horse with John Moran. I don't think you want that smoke.
No, but I don't really think I do either.
Did you play baseball? You'd be a hell of a pitcher too,
no,
right?
No, sir, I never played
none
baseball.
Of it.
Mm-mm, just football, basketball.
And you started playing football at what age?
6 years old, 7 years old.
Is Texas football?
Is exactly what you think it is.
It is.
Yes, sir.
Ridiculous.
It's like religion.
People cared about your high school team mm-hmm. in a way that was intensely outsized. Is that fair?
Yeah.
Like as compared to what probably most kids go through.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
How many people came to those games?
Packed out. People standing around the side.
How many would you say?
I don't know.
Thousands at every game.
Like 5,000?
No.
Do you have any idea how big the stadium was?
Our stadium wasn't big enough for that. But it would be people would be have to stand around the sides. Bleachers all full.
And then you obviously when you play in the state playoffs or something, it got even more obscene?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Do you remember when you broke the state record for touchdown passes?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
You broke the record for touchdown passes too?
Yeah.
Yards and touchdown passes?
So this is so
what the hell's wrong with you?
Yeah.
This guy is not awesome. I'm gonna barf.
No,
you gotta be awesome, Grant.
No. So here it is.
I mean, what in Texas? Like you did it in Idaho.
They won,
right?
Or Tennessee?
There's like a million guys that play quarterback in Texas that are NFL guys.
They won 55-14, 55-14 over Antonian Prep.
Antonian Prep?
Yeah, and he was
stink.
25 of 31 for 411 yards and six touchdowns in the first half.
Bro, who are you playing against?
Paxton Lynch did that against SMU in the first half of one game.
SMU.
Yeah.
Poor Chad Morris.
Yeah.
From Clemson. He's like, what the hell have I got myself into? I'm down 65-0 at half or whatever it was.
Is that Paxton's last year?
It was.
Yeah.
It was Fuente's last year.
Because it was Brett McMurphy reported at halftime of the game that Fuente was leaving for Virginia Tech. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. So who had the touchdown pass record? Falls or Breeze?
Something. Yeah, sir. I really didn't know.
Travis
Quintanilla.
Why is he just a good guy, you know?
I know he's a
It was Travis Quintanilla or Quintanilla or whatever.
Record. Who?
Travis.
That's what I didn't know.
Yeah.
Travis.
Travis Quintanilla. Yeah. It was his record. He had 184 and yours made it 185.
Does he still hold the record or did some kid come from behind
him? Yeah, you still have it.
Damn, Grant.
I know, big
damn
baller.
Grant.
Yeah, no flex. I mean, good grief.
And he didn't even want to tell us, did he?
No.
185 touchdowns.
I respect it, though.
16,000 yards.
You were the first Texas high school football quarterback to ever throw for over 15,000 yards. The first. The only one to ever do it.
Yeah, I know.
Hold on. They didn't have a running back.
Empty set. I was really the running back.
You were
QB draw.
You were
still. They know what you're doing the whole time, and they can't stop it. I mean, there's something to that.
Fair enough. Games changed quite a bit, right?
Exactly.
All right. So now we are going to be unveiling this show that is coming out. Did we decide on a name?
Yeah, the Grant Gunnell. And
no, stop that. Don't even go there.
Wait,
already.
Is it the Grant Gunnell show with Preston Brady? Is that what we landed
no,
on?
No, it's featuring Preston. It's the Preston and Grant show. It's the Preston and Grant show.
The Preston and Grant show?
Yeah, I think it should be like,
I don't think you're going to get him to agree to that.
I didn't agree to that.
No. All right. We're going to unveil it today.
All the Memphis people know who I am. Boys, they don't know who you are.
Do you find that to be true when he says all the Memphis people know who I am?
I do, because he can walk in anywhere and be like, what's up? Some random old
old 80-year-old.
Old 80-year-old. Gibson's donuts.
Who am I dabbing up that's 80 like this?
Who am I walking up to that's 80 years old dabbing up?
Or he'll be... It is walking true. To Gibson.
That'd be funny if you walked into Gibson's and you and the 80-year-old's got like a secret handshake.
That was after NIL.
So wait, hold on now. You've been, I guess you've bounced around town with him, gone downtown, whatever. You find that to be true, that Preston knows an outsized amount of people?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I say that, yeah. He's Mr. Memphis.
He is?
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate it. I do know a lot of people. It's also because of my dad. Yeah.
Your father, who is the head of ECS.
Exactly. Just a lot of connections.
And he was he PDS before?
Yeah, he was the...
he's been a school administrator your whole life,
he was
right?
doing, like, the dean of students at PDS.
Gotcha. All right. And so this show is going to be unveiled this afternoon. You guys are going to be doing this show the entire season.
Yep.
Right? There's going to be episodes that drop every week. First couple episodes... So the first one will drop today, which is just you guys, and then we have Jacoby Francis, Rodney Owens.
Yeah, Rodney Owens.
I believe,
yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. We've already gotten those guys. Obviously, we are awaiting the arrival of Calvin Austin. And then who else are you guys most looking forward to featuring on this show? And I promise you, for everybody out there, this is not going to be a show like you think it's going to be a show.
Expecting football talk.
This is not football talk.
Yeah, if you want to hear football talk, don't look at
this. This is what NFL matchup is.
Yeah, it's not that.
It's not Gruden's QB camp.
This is not Gruden's QB camp.
No.
All right, who else do you think?
Sean Dykes is going to be good. I talked to Sean today about it.
You do?
He's excited.
So the team
He's
already,
been here 10 years, too.
Does the team know that this is happening?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, they do. Because I bet, right? Once you got Rodney and Jacoby to come do it, then
rumor spreads really quick.
We're gonna change the NIL game. I believe nobody has a media gig yet, do they?
Mm-mm,
no. I haven't read of any. Mm-mm. I saw that guy. What's his name? Ukulele or whatever.
Oh, Yuga, the Clemson
BYU.
What?
Yeah.
Paid for all their walk-ons scholarships.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah, but they have to work. You read that?
Well, they have to wear the brand.
Yeah,
That's all they have to do is wear the brand during the games and practices.
Oh, is that right? And then they got all their
They match
walk-ons.
The scholarship players.
They're about to have a lot more walk-ons.
Yeah. The whole team's on scholarship now.
I'd be a walk-on if I was getting paid.
You got another year of eligibility? You're going to be BYU?
No
Mr.
shot.
BYU?
No shot. No shot.
seriously, that guy, what is he, Dr. Pepper or something?
Dr. Pepper, yeah.
You know, Spencer Rattler signing autographs and doing appearances and crap like that. But
this is gonna be the best gig.
I think so too. I think
because you're gonna get to know everybody.
I think college athletic I think people around college sports are gonna see this and either try to emulate it or be jealous. Well, you guys have got a show. Nobody else in college sports has a show.
You know, the best part is, too, you get to know things about Memphis football players that you wouldn't get to know.
You would never know. No, I think people are really going to want to root for the team, too. Now, obviously, your end of the bargain is the team has to be good.
True.
Right? So, I mean, we don't want to focus too much on... Because inevitably, it'd be like, Greg and Elsa spent less time filming videos and more time in his Playboy.
It's going to be good, though. It's going to be great.
We're going to spend a little time filming a video. There you go. That's coming. First loss. Just wait.
Just spend less time filming.
How about instead of making those stupid videos, he goes get your playbook.
Get focus. Down the studio.
we got some good special guests, though.
Oh, yeah.
Some good ones.
No, great ones. Look, your first two guests are amazing. Do you guys
those are funny.
Yes, we got two really good ones. So we're going to be unveiling episodes as the season goes on, and then we'll be catching up with these guys as the season goes on, which is now, what, 2 weeks away?
Yeah, it's...
Something like that?
Yeah.
You got
right
a couple weeks.
Right around the corner.
Right around the corner.
It's August 13th. Yeah, it's two to three weeks. Yep.
What's the day? They're first. What's your first one?
September 4th.
Nichols?
Uh-huh.
Sure.
Is that right?
And then Arkansas State, and then Mississippi State.
Oof. Getting heavy quick.
Real quick.
Yeah, 3 weeks from tomorrow.
What time is that game? The Nichols game. Six. Does it say?
Six.
Yeah. It's a night game.
The first three games.
And it's Grant Gunnell's debut. What number are you wearing?
Not yet. We're still competing. Quarterback competition.
Are you wearing seven?
Yes, sir.
You are?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the QB competition's still going. Competition.
Oh, it is?
Mm-hmm. You never know. There's no
God, I'm going to have to replace you with a starter?
Yeah. There's no one named.
It's, by the way, is the other guy the guy that the record he broke, Travis, whatever?
He crossed my name out.
We'll just cross
your name. Yeah, we're going to cross your name out with whoever the starter is. I mean, if you broke every record in Texas, you better start. God.
Is there a reason you wear number seven, like a player?
No, sir. Well, they used to call me, you know.
Michael
Vick 2.0.
They call you Michael Vick 2.0. You're like 8 inches taller than Michael Vick. Big, goofy, white guy and Michael Vick 2.0. Shut up, Grant.
Can we name that as the show?
What's that guy? What's our boy, Necky?
Oh, Mike Glennon.
Mike Glennon. You know, I got the neck. But Mike Glennon's like 6'6", too, right? Isn't he real tall?
Yeah, he's tall, yeah.
All right, you guys go back to practice. Enjoy it. Unveiling it this afternoon. It will be up. Preston and Grant show.
There it is. That's right.
Preston and Grant.
No.
It's Preston and Grant show. Get that right.
Not real thrilled. 2 p.m. today. So you got an hour. People are going to be able to find it on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, everywhere. New web series. NIL series with Preston Brady and Grant Gunnell. All right, get back to the facility. Thanks, fellas.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
There's Preston Brady and Grant Gunnell. We'll be back after these words.
The best NBA / rap / music collab.
There's a long history of this in the NBA. Jason Kidd, Gary Payton, Allen Iverson were on our test. Chris Webber, Kobe, Jack, Damian Lillard.
Dame Dalla, Lou Williams. Lonzo Ball, I feel like that's in the future for the Grizzlies.
It should be, right? We should get like John Jaren to, maybe we should do a song together.
Join Lang Whitaker and me, Kelsey Ray Johnson, every Thursday as we debate the hottest topics in the NBA. I am HO on GrindCityMedia.com, YouTube, and our social channels.
Kane Brown, Blessed and Free Tour. Saturday, October 23rd, FedEx Forum. Special guests, Jordan Davis. And Restless Road. See the meteoric rise of Kane Brown live. Tickets are on sale now at KaneBrownMusic.com. Presented by AEG Presents.
Represent Every Day, presented by Delta Dental of Tennessee, is an incentive-based program focused on keeping youth K through 6th grade engaged in school in order to combat truancy. In partnership with Shelby County Schools and with the help of Delta Dental of Tennessee, the Grizzlies are focused on reducing chronic absenteeism among the most impacted schools in the Mid-South. Students in the program have the opportunity to win fun and unique prizes by going to school every day and being engaged in the classroom. For more information on the program, visit Grizzlies.com/community/education today.
Don't miss the newest Grind City Media podcast, Infield Fly, with me, Rob Fisher, along with Lang Whitaker and Keith Murphy. Comes out each Tuesday, and we'll have the latest on our favorite teams and yours, regional and superstation teams, the Cardinals, Braves, and Cubs. While going around the horn to check in on the rest of the league, be sure to subscribe today at GrindCityMedia.com, iTunes, Spotify, and SoundCloud.
When you hire Nahon Saharovich and Trotz to handle your serious car or truck wreck case, we get right down to business. By sending out our rapid response team with all the resources to visit the accident scene, talk to witnesses, and consult with the necessary experts. To help you get paid for your injuries, call 683-7000. Hurt in a car or truck wreck? Think fast. Call Team NST today.
Call 683-7000.
WinBet is live in Tennessee and bringing you the action of real money sports betting right in the palm of your hand. Now you can get in on the action with all of your favorite teams across NBA, NFL, NHL, MLB, MLS, and more. Don't forget to take advantage of the generous promos, great odds, and unique parlays available in Tennessee on the WinBet app. Head to the App Store to download the WinBet app and sign up today. First-time bettors will receive a risk-free sports bet of up to $500. Terms and conditions apply for all promotion. Get the details at winbet.com.
WYNNBET.com. Must be 21 or older and present in Tennessee. Gambling problem? Call the Tennessee Red Line, 1-800-889-9789.
My name's Tony Tornado. I write and star in my own shows and movies. My crew knows that I dream of Hollywood. They also know that I love Mountain Dew. But there's so much more they don't know. Sometimes at night, I look up at the stars and think, I know why Mountain Dew's so crucial to my existence, but does anybody else? See, Dew's the green gold circulating through my veins. It makes Tony Tornado believe that he can do anything. So now you know my secret. But there's so much more you don't know.
Do the Dew.
Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow. Friday, December 3rd at FedEx Forum. With special guests, the Marcus King Band.
You wanna drink a water, got to go to the well.
And Yola.
Take a ride out in the country.
I can be Yola.
On sale now. Buy tickets at LiveNation.com or the FedEx Forum box office. Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow.
Have gold? Bring it to King. Grab everything you'll never wear again. King will buy all your gold jewelry or trade it for new jewelry and get 20% more. Have gemstones or diamonds you don't want to sell? Sentimental items passed down to you? King can use your gems or diamonds and create a new work of art designed with your own taste and style. Trade in your gold, let King design something that's all yours, or sell us your gold. There's no better time than now. During gold buying and custom design days at King Furs and Fine Jewelry in Laurelwood, where custom design is our specialty.
It's just a few cocktails at happy hour.
There aren't any cops around.
After every game, we always have a few. It's no big deal.
It was just a few drinks. I'm good.
Hey, I can hold my liquor.
I drink and drive all the time.
If you put away some drinks, put away your keys. Fans don't let fans drive drunk. Brought to you by the Tennessee Highway Safety Office.
Welcome back to the Chris Vernon Show on GrindCityMedia.com. Presented by WinBet. Now, back to your host, Chris Vernon.
We don't have to worry about no money to have us a real good time. And we don't have to leave in the morning, the whole day just you and I.
That's right.
And it don't have to get any better. It's perfect, you in my life. If you're cool, then I'm cool, then we're cool. We don't have to worry about no groceries. We can fill up on love alone. If we ain't got enough for a movie, we can just sit at home
and chill.
Have a little role play, baby. Whatever turns you on. If you're cool, then I'm cool, then we're cool. If you're cool,
right, we're back. Chris Vernon Show.
Go get the WinBet app. Go to your app store and type in WinBet Tennessee, and you can get a $500 risk-free first sports bet. You can bet $5, $10, $100, all the way up to $500 risk-free, because even if you lose it, they will credit that money back to your account. WinBet. But go ahead and win on WinBet. Go to your app store and download the WinBet app today. It is legal in the state of Tennessee. College football right around the corner. We were talking about some of those Memphis odds yesterday. Appreciate those guys coming in. Grant Gunnell and Preston Brady, the show that they have is going to be unveiled this afternoon. The Preston and Grant Show, or whatever it's going to be called.
The Grant Gunnell Show featuring
the Grant
Preston.
Gunnell Show.
We don't know.
Featuring Preston.
They the show will probably be done for the season at some point. At the end of the year, they still won't have a name for
it's
it.
It's going to be a web series, and you are going to be very entertained by it. I promise you that.
Yep.
And you're going to get to know them and other Memphis football players in a cool way for them to learn about the this business and get involved a little bit. And also something that was just not available in the past, right, for players to be able to do stuff like this. And so we want to take advantage of the fact that the name, image, and likeness stuff is available for those guys and try to come up with something cool to do with them. And I think we did, and I think you're going to love it. I do. It's going to come out this afternoon. And then there's going to be episodes every single week. We got a couple in the can, and I obviously I'm helping them with it. They're good. They're really good, and they're funny. They're lighthearted, and I think you're going to have a good time watching them. Probably not what you expect. It's not like a podcast. It's not X's and O's. It's going to be – they're going to be funny episodes every week from those two who are really good. And I did not realize the whole – I knew that Grant broke records in the state of Texas. I did not realize he broke the two biggest.
Yeah.
Those are – I mean, passing yards or passing touchdowns are the two biggest. You said Nick Foles or Drew Brees or – I don't know.
Or Johnny Unitas and Joe Montana.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anybody can go look him up on YouTube. The kid, he could chuck it now.
Yeah, he can.
And he's huge.
He is big, man. He's yes, a big he
guy.
Is.
And he's about the nicest guy in the world.
He is super nice.
Truly.
Yes.
Trying to get him to be a prick has been very difficult. Preston.
Texas.
Preston, on the other hand, a great personality. He's been a... he's been great for that football team, and he's college football royalty. The guy won the Mortell Award as the best holder in the world. So anyway, that show is going to be coming out later today. I just read this headline about when I was scrolling through things to see if anything had happened since we started the show today, and one of them was Thornton, 42, signs 1-year deal with the Panthers. And I was like, what? 42? And I clicked on it. It's like, you know, it's a hockey player, yeah. Joe Thornton, right? It said it's going to be his 24th season. And I was like, damn, bro. Like, is that going to break a record? So I tried to just Google this and look.
Chris Chelios probably played longer than that.
George Blanda.
Oh, yeah.
As a quarterback and a kicker, played in the NFL for 26 years. Now, what's Brady at? 20? Maybe.
Brady's more than 20. Brady's
because he just turned what? 40? Did he just turn 44?
Yeah.
Something like that. It was just his birthday. Isn't that what he turned? How many years did he play?
He's 44. He has been in the league since 2000, so.
Was 21 years.
This will be 21.
Damn, he's got to play for five more. Vince Carter played 22 years.
Yeah.
In the NBA. That was obviously a super long time. Bro, when I was scrolling through this, like they had like different athletes that played their sports forever. Try breaking this one. Gary Player. I this almost didn't seem real. The Black Knight himself, Gary Player. He played in 52 Masters. Bro, what? 52?
Gary Player?
He said he played in 52 Masters. He won it three times.
Wow.
Bro, you played in 52?
That's a lot.
Said he, in 2009,
this is his last
he made
one.
His final appearance in the Masters. In total, he participated in 52 Masters.
Wow.
He made his first PGA appearance in 1957. And he played in the 2009 Masters. What is that?
That's... how long did you say Thornton?
Gordie Howe played until his early 50s. He played...
Gordie Howe and Chris Chelios both played 26 seasons.
26?
Yeah, Gordie Howe and Chris Chelios, yep.
Okay.
26 seasons apiece.
So those are going to be the ones that are going to be, like, impossible, right?
Yeah. Those are...
Well, I don't know.
Hockey...
just signed a one-year deal. Nolan Ryan pitched for 27 years? 27? I didn't realize he was there for 27 years. God bless America. Some of these guys, yeah. I don't know, because I thought that when I saw the Joe Thornton thing, I was like, wow, that's an awful long time. There can't be that many. But, I mean, you see some of these, it's just extreme.
Yeah.
Can you imagine playing for 27 years? Most of these pitchers can't get to their, like, big payday before they blow out their arm five times. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, guys that were, like, number one prospects, like, 10 years ago are, like, you know, closers or something somewhere. They can't even – they can't make it.
Yeah.
You know what I think part – yeah. I don't want to –
I think
they don't throw enough?
No. Everybody always focuses on all the throwing stuff, right? All the throwing stuff. Do you know what I think plays a huge role in a lot of this? This is my opinion. I really believe that it is the foods. I do. I believe that I think that people that grew up and they ate real food, like from animals, right? And it wasn't the same. The diet now is so bad and in many cases downright toxic that I do think that there are some guys that I think that you're yes, the throwing is part of it, whatever, but it's not like Nolan Ryan didn't throw 100 million baseballs, right? Like, why did some of these guys? I think you found that because guess who else? Guess who, like, has the cleanest eating dude going? Who is it? Who's the cleanest eating
Brady.
Dude? Now, it's Tom Brady. Do you think that he is just like a magic man, that he was just born and he's just genetically superior to his peer? Like, no. I really believe in that. I do.
Well,
I think there's a reason that he is at his level of performance, at his age, and able to do it as long as he can. I believe that whether it's muscles, whether it's bones, whether it's, you know, growing, all of these things. And look, I'm not standing on some pedestal. My kids eat crap. Now, by and large, we don't eat a lot of fast food, right? But that doesn't stop. Like, he saw the Drip Lord. He saw something the other day on, I don't know, TikTok or YouTube or somewhere. And he's been doing. Now, think about how outrageous this is. You know what he's been doing? And he, like, wants it. He wants us to get it at, like, the supermarket for him. And I'm like, this is... He saw some video and they're like, you know what's awesome? And then they had, what's the thing that he likes that's hot? You know, not the hot fries, the other thing.
Oh, the,
what are they called? I never eat them. You know, the thing you get at the gas station. But you don't even see them at supermarkets. It's only gas stations. Takis.
Takis, yeah. I was going to say Zaki. Yeah, Takis.
Takis.
Takis, yeah.
Takis and ramen. You know, my wife is there, like, cooking ramen on the stove. I'm like, why are you making ramen? Like, this is what I ate in college. Why do you want this? And then he, like, they crumple up Takis in it. And that's what he eats. Ramen and Takis. I mean, it's trash.
Yeah, that's...
You know what I'm saying? They saw some video and he likes it, whatever. And, of course, they eat kid stuff. But I would say, look, they've always been big on fruit, and they've always been big on vegetables, right? Yeah. Like, my wife shoves that. Not shoves it. They don't mind it, right? Like, they always have broccoli or beans or some kind of... They are not adverse to...
Yeah.
They've never been adverse to that. She started that very, very young, right? But I also hear him sneaking in there grabbing a handful of Oreos or something, right? They're kids. And goldfish or whatever else. And all I'm saying is... And we don't really, very little fast food. So it's better, I guess, than some. But I certainly would not hold it out on a pedestal of, look, I don't feed my kids this bull crap, right? But I do think that, like, you know, my...
Look at Derrick Rose. When he got, you know...
Yeah, he...
It was well known that he ate, like, crap. Like,
terrible.
Like, ate candy all the time.
And
like,
so when I see something like that, like the whole, like, Nolan Ryan pitched for 27 years or whatever, and I think that's true of a lot of guys, I think that there was a generation and previous generations, like, they ate real food. You know what I'm saying? Like, they grew up eating real food. Even if it was, like, what you would consider bad food. Like, you hear about this, like, primal stuff, and you hear about this, like, whatever. Like, and I know age expectancies, you know, longer now, whatever. Yeah, but that's also because everybody's on friggin' pills.
Yeah.
I mean, my mom takes heart pills, and my dad takes blood pressure pills, and they, you know, like, they all, everybody's got pills.
Medicine's advanced.
Everybody's parents have pills.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
not taking any, somebody that doesn't take any pills for nothing, like you, it's hard to find, right? Especially yeah. old, right? And so that's a different thing now too. But like when they grew up, like yeah, like my grandma probably cooked with lard and stuff, but like it like legit came from an animal. You know what I mean? Like the stuff that they made, and like when everybody now you gotta pay like $10 to get a crate of eggs that my mom would like have to go out and like they had chickens.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like she grew up on a farm, so it's a little bit different. But like I told you this the other day, Roser, like it wakes me up when I see my father-in-law, he gardens. Like not as a profession, for fun. Like he's got a bunch of land and he's got a field that he grows all manner of things. And he'll go down and he'll put them all in the back of a pickup truck and he'll go to like some parking lot where everybody in the little town meets up and you can go by there in the mornings and he's like selling watermelons or he's selling crates of tomatoes or corn or whatever it may be, right? So you make a couple extra bucks doing it and he enjoys it. He likes it. Likes doing it. So I gave you a couple weeks ago, he'll come over and he'll give us like tomatoes.
Yeah.
Bring us like a crate of tomatoes, right? Well, if you don't eat those tomatoes by the end of the week, they're done. Right? You're not eating them anymore.
Yeah.
They spoil. They go bad, right? I buy a tomato at Kroger. I sit it out on the counter. Thing looks the same 6 months later if you don't touch it. So what is going on here? Like, it's not even the same food.
Yeah.
How is that possible? But what I'm saying is, you had a whole generation of people that's what they ate. They ate, like, actual stuff that, and you gotta, you know, whether it's you're injecting the chicken, I mean, hell, I've watched enough of these Netflix things to scare the hell out of me. And I'm not radicalized or anything, but I am aware that I think that is part of it. And I absolutely believe that part of the reason for the longevity of Tom Brady, it's not quack science. There's something to it. You hear all these people getting on plant-based stuff and then they like stop taking medicines. Like all these problems that they've had.
Yeah.
All these problems that they've had their whole life. You know, maybe they've had like tragic heartburn or they've had like you know, in some cases, it'll be like arthritis or it'll be like knee pain or whatever. And like stuff they take medicine for, and they get on these plant-based diets and all of a sudden, like they don't have that stuff happening to them anymore. And that's not a lie. Like that's really true.
No, I can tell you.
And so like what happened
here?
Yeah,
I can tell you for me, I have cut out. I have had fast food once. And I had half of a can of ginger ale on our flight back from Chicago. That is the only fast food and soft drink I have had in almost 5 months. Last time I went to the doctor, my blood pressure is the absolute best it has been in, I don't know, 3 years probably.
So how can we say that when
better and I don't put nearly as much bad stuff in my body.
And I even look at like my own kids or whatever, but I'm saying kids. Back then, you didn't go to the store. Like, my parents didn't grow up with a bunch of crap in their house.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying they're the beacons of health or anything. What I am saying is, like, is that rain?
That is rain. I didn't know it was supposed to rain today.
Not only is it, for those of you that are just listening and not watching, I'm sorry, but these raindrops look like hail.
Yeah, they do.
The biggest raindrops I ever seen in my life. What is going on?
How long
it just started
this
pouring out of nowhere outside. Oh, great.
It's a 30% chance for the next hour. It's light rain for the next hour.
Dude, do you know what somebody told me the other day? Did I already say this on the air? I don't think I did. I saw that. It wasn't somebody told me. I saw a video about it. And it was one of those moments where you're like, wait, what? It said that when you look at your phone right there and it says 30%, that's not what that means. That it's 100% chance of rain in 30% of the area.
Oh.
Nobody knows that, right?
I didn't know that.
I didn't either.
I was like, my whole life I've been sitting there going, oh, it's got 80% chance of rain tomorrow. No, it's saying it is going to rain, but it's only going to rain in 30% of whatever the area is that you're talking about.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you'll be out there and you'll be like, oh, it's not raining. You know, it said it was going to rain. Yeah, I didn't know.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know. That's what it said.
Huh. Yeah. Well, you learn something every day.
I was like, that makes – well, on the Chris Vernon show you do. Not in World. You just got to count on me watching stupid videos some more.
Lucky for us.
Lucky for you.
Lucky for
I ain't
us.
Slowing down, folks.
YouTube game is strong.
I am not slowing down. It is only getting more prevalent. This stuff is coming out sideways.
Yeah,
this end
it
of
is.
Days. What is happening?
This is end of days, and you look like you're dressed for golf. So.
Oh, fooey manooey. Ugh. Of course. Yeah, maybe it'll cool things off outside. Grizzlies play what time tonight?
I think it's
8 or 9.
Yeah, they play SAC tonight. I remember it being a night game, so that's good. And then we got preseason football all weekend long. And then by next week, I'll be getting some people on. It's at 8. ESPNU.
It's at 8.
Perfect.
By the way, because I just went to ESPN, I looked at the front page. Dude, what the hell is going on with Michael Thomas? Like, I haven't really even read up. I just, every time I see something, it's like there's something new with Mike. Does he just, like, hate the front office?
Yes.
Okay.
Here's the thing, bro.
These wide receivers, man, they, like, him and Antonio Brown were, like, both the quiet, humble guys, and then they just get awesome, and it's like, they just.
I know.
Off the meter. Off the meter, man. Something's bothering them, and they start speaking their mind.
Off the meter.
Yeah.
Truly. I saw this tweet the other day, and I can't. Oh, man. I can't remember the context of it, but it was basically. It was somebody responding to Michael Thomas's tweet. Did you see it?
No.
It was the. Okay, so Michael Thomas, he can't catch Mike, right? Can't guard Mike. Okay, yeah. Can't guard Mike. So Michael Thomas had this can't guard Mike thing he put up, and he had this. That's what made everybody go crazy about what he was. That's when everybody knew that he was like all mad.
They tried to damage your reputation.
Huh?
The reputation thing.
Yes, the reputation.
They tried to damage your reputation. You saved theirs by not telling your side of the story.
Right. And then if you scroll down, this made me laugh so hard. It, you scroll down, it says typical quarterback tweet. Love my teammates. God is good. Typical running back tweet. Keep grinding. Typical tight end tweet. Derp. Typical wide receiver tweet. The enemy speaks kindly and holds a knife. It's true. Wide receivers are always like that.
They are.
They stab you in your back and smile in your face. Like, they're always so mad about everything. Running back tweet, keep grinding. It is a personality trait. They're always mad about something. I guess it takes a different... takes a different personality to be amazing at that position, too.
I mean, that's true.
It does.
Yeah.
Who knows? Anyway, should be a fun weekend. Grizz is going to be continuing this summer league stuff. We've got a million preseason games, and then we'll be getting ready for football as of next week. Thanks to Grant Gunnell and Preston Brady. Thanks to John Roser across the glass. Thanks to Kimball back in the studio. Until Monday, have a wonderful and safe weekend. Until then, we go. Full-grown man.